We call them the pack attack. They come up there
and they
come in full force. They got their banners and we let them bring in their own food and stuff, which is fine. We enjoy having them up there, and they get excited, and it's
every football game?
Oh yeah, they don't miss, and they're very superstitious. So again, it was good that they were winning, because then they wouldn't leave our place, because they figure if they watch the game somewhere else, they're gonna lose. So it was a good situation. I think we're gonna see quite a few of those people back and some. So I'm
probably
sure.
And some more. I'm sure I get called this pack attack, because I am like a huge pack attack.
Well, that's what I call them. I don't know if that's what they want to be called, but that's what I call them, because
they
come ripping in there, and they got all their Green Bay Packer stuff on, and their banners and flags and everything else, and they have a good time, and it's fun to watch, and I absolutely love it when they play the Vikings. It's great.
Oh, that has to be like the best game of the year. Super Bowl.
Yeah.
I mean, that's the game, and
they get excited, and we do all. For some reason, we've kind of got a nice following now for football, and I hope to continue to see that grow and get some more people in there, because it's fun to watch them kind of bicker at each other and have fun with it. So it's
now cool. On the lodge side, though, I mean, do you guys have that same type
absolutely
of
pack? Yeah, we don't have as much of a football following. We got more of the fantasy players will come over to the lodge side with their computers and watch the games. And that's kind of a cool thing. I mean, obviously we offer Wi-Fi, and they can, you know, get online, and they follow their fantasy teams, and because it's more quiet, they can concentrate and they know what's going on. And so it's pretty cool. I kind of think that's an interesting time of year to watch those people come in, and it's exciting for me as a business owner, because you know it's the start of good things to come for the winter.
Okay, so now, do you have like any other events going on like throughout the rest of the summer? Because I know there was a time when you guys were offering bands and things like that.
Yeah, we're still doing that. I think we got our next band's like August 12th. I hope that date is correct. I'm pretty sure it is. But we try to spread them out. We have Dirty Word come in quite a bit. That's a big draw for us. They're kind of a local band that's done very well on the outside scene, so to speak. And they've got a following. I mean, they come in, and we pretty much know we're gonna have a pretty good night. So other than that, we don't do a ton of them. We just kind of more or less let people have fun and come on in and create their own excitement.
Enjoy what they want to enjoy.
Yeah, absolutely.
So now, being in a restaurant bar situation, I mean, there's got to be your favorite food item. What would you say is your favorite thing that you guys
have? Well, you know, for me, I learned here not too long ago that I'm allergic to flour, so I can't eat a lot of the stuff, which is unfortunate. But before this, I think the pizza that I brought in today for you guys is probably
one of my
top-notch choices. So.
For everybody to see, so you guys can see how awesome this pizza looks.
Yeah, this is pretty solid. And for a lot of folks, they don't know that we even serve pizza.
Oh, wow. So what kind of pizza is that?
This is a chicken mango. It's kind of a chef special, so to speak. He kind of ripped her up here for me to bring into you guys. And as you can see, we're missing a couple slices.
We are missing a couple pieces, and that's because of our camera crew guy. He got a little hungry here before we started this edition of City Chat with City Magazine.
Absolutely, but that's good. That's why we bring it in. But no, we've got a nice menu. You know, it's expanded. It kind of got bigger than what we wanted to.
Oh, wow.
Originally, but what happened was is we had some good items, and people didn't want to us to take them off. So it's kind of one of those things where once you offer it, you almost got to continue to offer it, and we've kind of grown. I mean, we've got burgers, steaks, Phillies are fantastic. I would say out of all the items that we sell, the Philly, the Dakota Sioux Philly is our most popular, and
it's
people
huge.
Love it. Yeah, absolutely love it. We got a great grinder, kind of a playoff to the red pepper, again, I like our menu, and we never really hear a lot of bad things about it, so that's always a good thing. As long as you're not getting any feedback, that's usually a good thing.
That is usually a good thing, because normally when it's bad, people tell everyone, but when it's good, they tell no one.
Yeah, absolutely, but that's fine. I mean, we got, like I said, I think we got one of the better menus in town as far as in a bar or restaurant atmosphere, so it's pretty cool.
Very cool. So now, besides being a hockey coach and a bar owner, you also have your own radio show.
I do.
Teach me.
Well, yeah, no, it's funny. I when I was playing hockey professionally, I'd always had aspirations to fish professionally as well, and I was fortunate enough, again, I had some great sponsors. I toured around the countryside fishing all the PWT and FLW events, and had, like I said, great sponsors. It's kind of taken a back seat now with the economy. The fishing, walleye fishing especially, hasn't kept up, so to speak, with the with the changeover, with the high gas prices and it was tough. But at the same time, I still try to stay involved. I'm working on a project that I'm hoping to release here pretty soon in the fishing world. It's an invention, and I'm excited about it. I've got a patent right now for it, and a lot of work. But at the same time, I want to get back into that industry, and it's fun, and I do. I have a radio show every Monday morning at 10:05 on 710 ESPN Radio. And we talk about pretty much everything as far as the fishing and hunting goes in the state of North Dakota. And then we always dabble with a little hockey in there as well. So I'm kind of always on the water. It might be frozen, but it might be open as well. But it's fun. I enjoy it.
So how did you get involved with doing this radio show? I mean, how did that even start?
Well, Jack Michaels had that show originally. And he called me out of the blue just saying, would you be interested in talking fishing for a half an hour on Mondays? I said, I'd absolutely love to. And we just kind of continue it. So I think we're on our third year already. And the show has switched over to Rick Anthony. And you know he's doing it, and he's doing a great job, and we're having fun. It's, you know, people, I kind of got a group now that seems to always let me know what's going on. If I don't give them the right information, it's pretty interesting. I get a lot of text messages, but that's pretty cool.
Oh, for funnies. So now that is every Monday, what time?
10:05 every Monday. So it's
10:05 till?
Yeah, usually about 10:30.
About a half hour long show.
Correct.
Or so.
Yep.
Oh, that's nice. That's
perfect.
It's like doable.
It is, because I can do it from anywhere. I can actually be in the boat if I want, or in my office, or wherever. You know, it's all on phone, and I enjoy it. And it's, you know, again, I like to pass on information, and for whatever reason, you know, fishing is one of those things that I just really hold close to myself as far as I enjoy it, and it's fun, and I don't want to let it go, and that's why I'm trying to get back in the industry. Absolutely.
Well, now you were talking about the economy and how that has affected that business, and being a small business owner yourself, and potentially coming out with your own invention. What advice would you give to other small business owners that are in this area?
Well, you know, you got to stay small. I don't, a lot of times you want to grow as fast as you can, and sometimes that's not a good thing. And I think if you took the stadium sports bar as an example, I mean, we started small. We started as just a bar. Didn't offer any food, and we've built it to two bars basically and two restaurants now. And it's at that point now where I don't want it any bigger. It's hard to maintain that level. So I think, I think if somebody were to come out with some sort of concept of keep it simple, keep it small, I think you do very well, and you know, try to keep your overhead down as much as you can. And you know, it's like anything right now, you gotta pinch pennies to make sure you save a couple, and that way you've got a backup plan in case something doesn't work.
So do you ever foresee like an offset of those two restaurants somewhere else in town?
We've been contacted actually to franchise it out of Bismarck.
Exciting.
Yeah, and we just, again, it takes a lot of resources and a lot of energy, and I don't know if we're ready for that quite yet, but maybe someday down the line we might expand a little bit in that regard and let somebody else handle it. You know, it's one of those things where it's a 24-hour-a-day job, and it never leaves you, but it's fun. I enjoy it, and it gives me the flexibility to do these other things, and that's what I really enjoy.
So where do you see the radio show going? Do you see that expanding?
Well, you know,
huge, or?
Obviously, if the opportunity presented itself, certainly. You know, I've been contacted too to do some TV programs and things like that. And again, it's time. You know, time and money is an important thing, as we all know. And I enjoy it. You know, I'm kind of a guy that likes to talk, and I like to pass on what I've learned and what I've experienced. And I hope people enjoy it. Maybe they don't, but at the same time, if you can give them anything as far as make their outings more enjoyable, I'm all for that.
Very cool. So now this fishing patent thing, you got me really kind of curious.
Yeah,
about
I suppose
that.
You know, it's, yeah, you know, I guess in the big picture, I can kind of give you a little bit of a briefing as far as what it is, being that I do have a patent on it. But I've come up with a concept, basically, one, to save money, and that's kind of a huge thing.
Yeah, for anybody.
Yes, for anybody. And one thing I've noticed in the fishing world right now is things are awfully expensive, and I'm as an angler, I've gotten very frustrated having to spend, you know, $8-$9 for a lure, $300 for a rod. It gets to the point where it's not enjoyable, because you're really trying to, you know, you got to, I mean, if you're not financially set as far as being able to have that extra income to, you know, buy these things, it makes it difficult. And again, I've come out with a concept, and I can't really release what it is exactly.
What it is exactly.
But it dabbles in a lot of things that we use on an everyday basis in the fishing world, and it will save people a lot of money. And I just hope it catches on as well as I think it will. The few people that are on the inside of this project think that it's a home run. But again, until you get it out into the
public,
the masses,
you never know.
But I again, as a fisherman, would I buy it? I'd buy a million of them. So
are you working to sell then your idea concept to a manufacturer to make it and then sell it?
No, at this point in time, I am in contracts with another company in town to help me move forward with this whole project. It's kind of gotten extensive. It's take back what I said about starting small with that other stuff.
Anything is huge. Yeah, whenever you want to patent something.
This has gotten a lot bigger than I originally had thought. I'd come up with the idea basically by default. I was driving down the street one day and it hit me, and I went home and I started doing a search on the internet to see if anybody had patented this idea. It wasn't there, and I was actually kind of shocked. It was almost to the point where, how did nobody ever think of this? And it's going to be interesting. It's going to be fun once this comes out. The company will continue to grow as we speak, and it is as we speak, but once it comes out, I think people will catch on to the concept pretty fast.
That is so exciting, because my husband and I, we actually went through a process like this. He you know, works for Burleigh County, and one day when he was on the road, he just all of a sudden, boom, had this idea, did a lot of research, and there was nothing out there for what he had thought of. And we started working with a patenting lawyer and contracting to, like, possibly see where this could go. But then there was already a patent pending for that had the same type of verbiage as to what our product would have been. And so it basically would have been putting thousands and thousands and thousands of dollars into maybe it never even getting past the patent process.
Yes, correct.
So
and that's where
I'm
at.
And being a new couple, we had to kind of abandon the idea. And I'm glad we did, because actually a couple months later, then I was looking through a magazine and there was something that kind of topped his idea already out on the market.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, and my guess is with this situation that I'm in with this company, I think there's going to be a couple companies that will probably not want to see it come out, but at the same time, that's a good situation to have, because, you know, if they want to buy it, that's fine, and we'll work something out that way. But again, I wanted to give people an opportunity to be able to enjoy fishing without having to spend millions of dollars.
Yeah, and that's like any hobby. I mean, any hobby seems to be expensive. So whenever you can save money, that's great.
Correct.
Well, thank you so very much. Now, really quick, where can people get to the stadium and the lodge? How do they get in touch with you? Facebook page?
We do have a Facebook page, obviously, Stadium Lodge. We're working on a website. We're still a little bit behind the times when it comes to that. But, you know, we're up on West Divide, 1247 West Divide, kind of up by the Cracker Barrel up in the Texas Roadhouse area. And you can't miss us. We got a couple pretty big signs
You're
up
closer
there.
To Central Market, though.
I absolutely. Right across the street from Central Market.
Central Market. That's probably a better place, because I could see people going to Texas and be like, where are
Where are we at? But correct. We're right there by Central Market, and it's a big place. You can't miss it.
Very cool. Well, thank you again for coming on the show today, and thank you again for everybody watching this edition of City Chat with City Magazine. Again, I'm Kylie Harmon, General Manager of City Magazine, and make sure you head to our website at thecitymag.com, where you can read the current issue, our current August issue, and also watch on our website past issues of City Chat with City Magazine. Have a good day.